How Epstein started at Pepperdine during the time I was the head basketball coach there, and the thing I love most about Al is his longevity, consistency, solid performance night in and night out. His preparation, the coming to the games and being prepared and knowing what's going on and knowing that outline of basketball. And I thought he just did a terrific job and certainly deserves to be in the Hall of Fame.
His role and his touch points at Pepperdine have really expanded dramatically. Of course, the one consistent has been that link with Pepperdine men's basketball for 30 years, dating back to the mid-1980s. A lot of success, a lot of tremendous moments, and he's been with the Waves every step of the way.
He did the radio all the time I was there, the first time I was there, and I came back after 14-year absence, and he was still back there doing the same thing. He's very professional. He went a lot of different directions in his professional career, but he just had that burning love and desire for the university. He loved to come out and work and relate to the coaches and the players, and he was just a consummate professional in everything he did.
Well, I first met Al before I even was associated with athletics. As a staff member, as the vice president of the university, I had a chance to interact with Al quite a bit and obviously listen to him, particularly when the team was on the road. And was always impressed with his professionalism, with his in-depth knowledge of our history and of our team and of the current players and coaches. And the story he would tell during the game, it was amazing.
Al is definitely a creature of habit, and when we were on the road, he always had his routine where 3 hours before game time, we would have a pre-game meal at a restaurant and then get to the arena 2 hours before, because he was always concerned that a phone line wasn't going to be working, so he always wanted to make sure that was working. And post-game, we always went out for a meal after that, and two staples of Al was always a Diet Coke and a cup of coffee.
A lot of guys don't really understand the game and don't really know what's going on. Al was one that really knew what was going on. He knew what was going on at Pepperdine. He knew what was going on in our conference. He knew what was going on the West Coast, and he knew what was going on nationally. And we used to have great conversations about basketball and players, and Al knew everybody.
There's three words that really stand out. One, passion. He's very passionate about his work as a broadcaster. He takes it very seriously. He has a good time doing it, but he's very passionate about it. Second would be his preparation. Al always prepared extensively for a broadcast. It's not like he would just walk in and wing it. He was always well prepared, copious notes, and could talk about a wide range of items. That was always entertaining for the listeners and provided a lot of information. And then the third would just be his professionalism. He always represents Pepperdine in a first-class manner all the time.
Al Epstein didn't do the job at Pepperdine for the money, as he'd be the first to tell you. He just did it for the love of the university, and he loved the sports, and he loved being around the coaches, and the players liked him. He traveled with us all the time. He's just a great guy, very well prepared.
Over the years, became the voice you expected to hear and to trust. And because of that, and because as I got to know him as an individual, you could see his commitment.
He got along with everybody. Everybody liked him. He was very personable, always had a smile on his face, always was up and positive and excited to do the game. He was excited to do Pepperdine basketball, and that's what he just fit right in with everybody, and it showed because he's lasted so long.
I think back in the times that we've worked together, we traveled literally all over the country with Pepperdine men's basketball, and a tremendous ambassador for the program and representing the college in a first-class manner at all times.
He's a great guy, and I miss being around him. He was a lot of fun to work with. He was always positive and upbeat with the team and with the coaches, and you know, he always had something positive to say, and in regard to the officials and everything. He was just a real pro.
He embodies the mission of Pepperdine, which is competing with purpose. Al definitely broadcasts with purpose. And Al, I just want to congratulate you on this great honor. It's greatly deserved, and I wish you all the best.